very similar document, but for a complete context, completely different. System requirement specification is internal. Request for proposal is external. That goes out for prospective suppliers. So by the end of the session, you'll be able to select a software evaluation methodology to effectively evaluate possible software solutions. Select a methodology and tools for evaluating hardware, operating system network. Evaluate vendors. List the inclusions of a service contract and prepare a request proposal. So that's the things I'll be looking for in the RFP. The request for proposal is a document that requests a proposal through a bidding process. Like you send out the proposal and people bid to provide a solution, which could be anything, but in our case it's for a computer system or a computer solution and a contract for services. So that's what an RFP is. So the sections in the RFP, it says up there to take care with, because that's the one, these are the ones I particularly look at to allocate the marks, is the overview and objectives of the buyer. So you need to describe to a prospective supplier who the buyer is, what they do, how their company is structured, so a supplier can understand the context into which they are proposing the supplier the solution. So copy it out of your previous documents. Easy peasy. Existing system. You need to tell the proposed supplier what existing systems they've got, because the supplier might decide that some of it is usable. Now they've all got bits and pieces of stuff, right? So put them in there. And if they don't have anything that's listed in the template, just say no, right? But don't make a mistake that a lot of groups do and put their future system in there. The word is existing, not future. So that's what they've got now. Solutions requirements. Here's another one that just baffles me as to why people get this wrong. It says software requirements. And it says, some groups will just put, yeah, we need application software and operating system. What do I propose? I have no idea. So the solution requirements is simply a copy from your system requirements specification of the application solution requirements and the platform requirements. Just copy it in. The supplier needs to see what the requirements are so he knows what to propose. Okay? So that comes straight out of your system requirement specification. Software evaluation, hardware evaluation, vendor evaluation, and contract inclusions are also things I look at when I'm marking the RFP, and we'll come to that shortly. So I'm going back to the start. That was supposed to be an introduction, but I got a bit carried away. So I'm going to start again. Right, overview and objectives. The buyers, I've said, just take it out of your strategic plan, previous documents. Existing systems is existing, not future. Solutions requirements, application software, and the platform, utilities, etc. Just get it from the SRS and copy it in. Easy. Right. Now we're back again to software evaluation. Software evaluation and hardware evaluation is different. Software, you can just tick it off. you've got a list of requirements, right? And you've got an evaluation methodology to evaluate. I mean, you might get three solutions proposed that have all got the same functionality, and they all meet your requirements. Which one are you going to select? The one that meets your requirement the best. So you need some kind of methodology to be able to evaluate which one meets your requirement the best. Evaluation matrix is a methodology that a lot of evaluators use. Evaluation rubric is another one. There's more, and there's a link to look them up. But I want you to tell me what software evaluation methodology you are proposing to use. Hardware evaluation is different. You can't just tick things off, because it's the combination of hardware that is making the hardware run. So you're talking about overall performance, overall reliability of the total hardware package. And there are three